safe at home. Okay, before teacher starts with the new topic, I want to ask you all that did you all revise the lessons or the topics that teacher has done in the month of June with you all? If you all have not revised, I want you all to go and check the videos and revise the lessons again that teacher has done in the month of June. And I know that you all will do it because you all are good children. So today's topic is one-to-one correspondence that comes under math. Now what is one-to-one correspondence? Teacher will tell you. In mathematics, one-to-one correspondence is a function between the elements of two sets, where each element of one set is paired with exactly one element of the other set, and each element of the other set is paired exactly with one element of the first set. I hope now you all have understood what is one-to-one correspondence. I'm joking. Okay, now I will tell you what is one-to-one correspondence in a very, very simple way. Now, you look at the board. What do you see? Set A and set B. Under set A, there are three objects, and under set B, teacher has drawn three objects. Now, in set A, let's see what are the objects in set A that teacher has drawn. There is a glass of juice, badminton, and a fork. Now, in set B, let's see what teacher has drawn. There is a shuttlecock, there is a spoon, and there is a straw. Now, we have to match objects from set A to set B. Now, let's see the first object in set A. It's a glass of juice. Now, we have to match glass of juice with the object that is in set B. Will you have juice with a shuttlecock? No. Will you have juice with a spoon? No. You will have juice with a straw. So now let's match glass of juice with a straw. Now let's see the second object. The second object over here is a badminton. Now let's match badminton to set B pictures. Will you play badminton with a spoon? No. Will you play badminton with a straw? No. You will play badminton with a shuttlecock. So we will match badminton to shuttlecock. Now let's see the third object. Third object is a fork. When you are having dinner, you will use a fork and a shuttlecock? No. Will you use fork and a straw? No. You will use fork and spoon. When you have your dinner, you use a fork and a spoon. Now, you have matched all the objects from set A to set B. This is in a very simple way what one-to-one correspondence means. Now, let's take more examples. See, I am back with more examples to teach you one-to-one correspondence. Now let's see what is there on first step. There is a bottle. Can you see the bottle? Yes. Now teacher wants to close this bottle. Can teacher use a pencil to close this bottle? No. Can teacher use a ball to close this bottle? No. Can teacher use a bottle cap to close the bottle? Yes. So, teacher has used a bottle cap to close the bottle. Now, let's see what is there on the second step. There is a book. What is there? Book. In the book, can teacher write with a ball? No. Can teacher write with a bat? teacher will write with a pencil. Now the last object is a bat. You all play bat, cricket, you all play cricket? Yes. Now, will you play with a pencil and a bat? No. Will you play bat with a book? No. Will you play bottle and bag? No. We will use a ball to play with a bat. Now these are some examples that teacher has shown you to teach you one-to-one correspondence. And I think that you all have understood what is one-to-one correspondence. So for now, until we meet the next time with a new video, bye.